Hello everyone. So, a few people have asked me how I modified my lock screen to get rid of some of the icons on there. It did take me a little bit of fiddling before I found it, but it's actually quite simple and quite customizable. So, go into your settings, go down to security, and in here you've got screen lock options. So here you can change the type of screen lock you want to use. So you can use the motion lock. I haven't tried that out yet. Meant to be quite good though. Face lock, face and voice, all of these things. Okay, but the option we want is in lock screen options. And in here, shortcuts. And you can see you've got a green ticky against it. If you then click on that, it will take you into set shortcuts. And you can see there one of your icons. You can set any icons you like. Obviously, I would suggest removing any of the ones that give people access to personal information, like the email one, for instance. I think the camera ones generally are right. You know, you've got to be careful with it, because at the end of the day, anyone who picks up your phone can access those apps quickly. So, you know, use a bit of common sense and only put the ones on that, whoops, you're not too worried about people accessing. So it's just stalled a little bit there. Okay. I think it generally depends if you're someone who's a road warrior, so there's a chance someone might be able to access your phone when you're not around, or whether you're someone who just sits in your house all day, and so you're not really worried. Very, very quick and easy. Let's just add Ted to it as well, for argument's sake. Then you press your back button, back again, come all the way out, and we'll turn the phone off. And there's our icons. Quick and easy. If I want to access one, I simply press and move it to the outside. And there's Astro. Quick and easy customization of those buttons. It's a shame there's not a few more options, like being able to move them around into different places and things like that, but hey, it's nice to have those features. But like I say, use a bit of common sense, don't put anything on there that you wouldn't want anybody to be able to access at the end of the day. I'm now going to go and change some of those options. Hello everyone. Okay, so a few people have been having problems when they've been playing videos on their S3. Now, it's no problem, for instance, like stalling or anything like that, but it's more when you've got the phone in your hands, or when you're picking it up and so on, or you've popped it onto a stand. If you tap any of the buttons or touch the screen or anything like that, then all of the Chrome pops back up again and you've got to wait or press the button again to get it to go away in full screen. But it turns out there's a way to lock the screen. And I'm hoping they'll introduce this into some of their other apps as well, or at very least make it a global feature, because certainly for gaming it would be absolutely fantastic. So. Personal. There we go. Let's just have a look at that Wonders of Nature one. Now, so you can see there, it's turned around, and every time I touch anything, if I touch any of these buttons, Chrome's popping up. So, press your power button once, and you can see up here in the corner, you've now got a little symbol, a padlock, and all of these buttons and the screen are not reacting. That's strobing quite a bit on the camera. But yep, there's a lock. Press the power button again, lock screen goes away, and up comes the Chrome. Press power button, it's locked. Nice and easy. Like I say, I really hope they introduce this for many other apps, because it's very, very useful. I don't know whether it's available in the SDK at all, but quick and easy, locks the screen. You can no longer interact with it. Perfect. Hello everyone. Right. So, a few people have been asking how you stop S-Voice from activating when you use the double click on your home button. So, just to show you how that works, let's just get rid of S-Voice. You can see it's so annoying. So, say I'm away in my browser, I double click there, my phone then stalls, and then S-Voice comes up. Marvellous. I really don't want that. I don't like S-Voice. I want a shot of it. I certainly don't want it.
I'm not sure what you mean by an S-Voice comes up.
Yeah, quite. So, to get rid of it, we go click on your settings option here, go into your settings, launch S-Voice. Launch S-Voice by double pressing the home key. Go away. Then you can also go here in here and tweak a load of other S-Voice related stuff as well. Turn it off, wake up in Samsung Unlock. Only listen while charging. All those nice little things to really tweak it to your liking, or if you really want to, just turn the damn thing off. Then go back. And that's it, S-Voice is gone. If we double tap now, it doesn't do anything. No more S-Voice, hooray! Hi, So a lot of people are interested in motion activation. Come into settings, in motion, and then flick on the ones you're interested in. You've got direct call, call contact currently displayed on the screen. So if you lift the phone to your face with the contact displayed on the screen, it will automatically start dialing them. Smart alert. Some really, really clever little actions in here. Okay, so a lot of people are interested in the connectivity options that are coming through on Android, and so on the S3 in particular. If you go into settings, and you go into more settings, in there you have a host of other options. So you can flick your flight mode on and off. Samsung have a system called Keys, which allows you to connect to your PC, basically, and Keys-based devices. I haven't tried that yet. VPN connection, for those of you in corporate networks or worried about your own security. Tethering and portable hotspot, yay. I'm in the UK and it was enabled. If you're in America, good luck, and sorry about that. NFC, for those of you like using NFC tags like me, or if you're looking to tap your phone together. Android Beam, which is basically the same thing but allows you to transmit content. S Beam, which is Samsung's version of NFC, I think. Wi-Fi Direct. Seen this on a couple of Android devices, but seems to be Samsung in particular. If you set that up, it works very similar to NFC, except it will, or Bluetooth, if you've ever used Bluetooth sharing. Two phones with Wi-Fi Direct, you can connect but and share your devices, your files and what have you much quicker. If you've got a PS3, Xbox, something like that, DLNA, hook your mobile phone up to your PS3 or Xbox remotely, and you can share your content from your PS3 from your S3 directly to your PS3. And then mobile networks, which is for those of you that want to change any of your mobile settings, data roaming, everything like that. All tucked away in one nice, easy area, not spread around like in some other handsets. Dum-de-dum. That's about it for your settings.